to judge, right? Because I got personal preference. Personal preference, I like Ross and I like Chainz. But when you hear the music, you got to sit back and say, that damn Ross got a different type of catalog, man.
Listen, his list has been up in my studio for 2 weeks. Y'all, like, I wasn't surprised at no song he played. Y'all fucking with the right one when you come to this. Listen, he had more pressure than me because he had more material. Yeah. I knew I had, y'all about 20 hits, right? That what y'all talking about, 20 hits?
Yeah.
Y'all said 20 hits.
Yeah.
I played 23 hits. I'm not going back and forth with catalogs and all that. You say you want to hear some hits. I played plaque after plaque after plaque after plaque. And so another thing that I was doing was I wasn't doing no rounds. I was just playing hit for hit for hit for hit. I wasn't going back and forth with no catalog,
okay.
No who did this, no big homie, little homie, all of us, just me. It wasn't about none of that shit. This shit
just
was
hits.
About, this is another plaque, this is another hit. I did the hook. I motherfucking did a 16. I was the hardest nigga on this whole song. That's what that was about.
We can't talk like this, man.
Were there some songs afterward that you were like, damn, I should have played that? Because, you know, people always respond on social media and they're like, you missed this song, you missed this song. Are there some songs you feel like you missed?
Angela, I was 1,000% focused on this shit. I don't know what niggas was doing the night before. I was rehearsing for a couple of hours. I was getting my shit together. I knew I was going to spit over TV tracks. That's what I do at shows. I knew I was going to have narrative behind it. I knew that I was going to have content with dancers. Y'all got to know that I'm one of the best minds in this shit, marketing minds. Y'all know me and Tech been doing this shit for the longest. You know, ain't no big diss behind me, no big diss. Y'all know this shit comes straight from me. The idea comes straight from me. Y'all gonna give me my roses so I can smell them. All that other shit y'all talking about ain't about nothing. We talking about playing 20 hits back to back. That's what I did. I don't care what nobody else, I'm gonna always have my 20 hits. If they go up to 30, I can still be in this contest. If they go up to 40, I might can hang in a little longer. I'm just being real, you know what I'm saying? Like, let's talk about, and then, you know, we talk about other stuff that's different. Man, did I know this man had this? He got way more shit than that. I had a whole list of shit that he didn't do. At least 10 records that I felt that he was going to do that he didn't do. So I wasn't surprised and that he dropped. I'm just surprised that y'all don't see how hard I am. That's what I'm surprised.
No, I thought it was a
pretty.
I thought it was a pretty.
We
and I said that on the air this morning. I thought
Listen, not y'all. Not y'all. You fuck with me too hard. Not y'all. Come on now. But y'all.
Listen.
They don't give you the respect like that. Why? They do give
Chainz respect.
I always felt like I had to work 5 or 10 times harder to be at the same point another person has, and I'm kind of immune to it. It doesn't bother me at all. Please don't take this as frustration, because if it is, it's probably just because I'm asleep. For the most part, I always, and people that's close to me know that I have these tantrums about me wanting to have my roses where I can smell them. You know what I'm saying? Don't be trying to die to be telling me how ill I was on this song. Man, fuck all that shit. You know what I mean? I've been popping my shit. Since I left serving the peace, I've been kicking. I've been a millionaire. I've been taking care of my family, my motherfucking community. I own basketball teams. I own beverages. I own restaurants. Shout out to Escobar. Members only. I have 2 Escobars. About to open up a third one. Stop playing with me.
Everybody.
So it came from you, Ross? Was it your thought to do it with 2 Chainz?
Nah. Swiss hit me and told me to play. You know what I'm saying? I done got a lot of paper with Swiss. Swiss always been a genuine dude. I ain't even questioning it. That's what you want to do, homie. You already know what it is. You know, I'm sure you see what the streets was talking about. But, you know, everybody ain't going to want to just get next to Rosé like that.
That's why it's hard.
Yeah. And that's why I was commendable for the homie to do his thing. And not on no funny shit, but, you know, I came with a cool 20-pack and got 20 more for somebody else to really step up and say, and I'm going to play 20 different ones. Yeah.
See, I love that. That's the kind of trash talk I'm here for, Ebro. A second round, another 20, if you will.
So Ross, you're basically saying you'll go again. Whoever won it, you got more smoke. You got more gas in the tank.
More gas in the tank? I ain't played none of my number one records and shit, you know. I might have played Fuck With Me, you know I got it. That's one whole collaboration. I may have played Live Fast, Die Young, but like a lot of my cultural shit that I, you know, turn up in arenas, you know what I'm saying? You know, super high, magnificent,
yeah.
Luxury tax,
big money. It's a big money bank.
Here I am.
Money.
You know, I left those type of records for somebody else who want to step up, and I'm going to get them in the door.